President Biden's pick for U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations, Linda Thomas-Greenfield. She gave a speech praising China in the past, saying the world should follow its example. Katie McFarland with us this morning. All right, Katie, you follow this very, very closely. Is President Biden about to cave to China? What do you think?
Yeah, I don't think it was ever tough to begin with. Look, the Biden administration has been in for 1 week, and Stuart, their motto seems to be, watch what we say, don't watch what we do. Because they talk tough. I mean, every one of these nominees has gone to Capitol Hill and said, we're going to be tough on China, we're going to be tough on China. But then what have they done? I mean, in the last week, they've done things like the new Commerce Secretary says, we're not going to ban Huawei from the, inside the U.S. networks. They've taken a ban that President Trump put on Americans investing in Chinese military companies. They've lifted that ban. And yet at the same time, China responds by saying, we're going to ban any American company that hires anybody and does any business with the people who have been in the Trump administration. So it's one thing after another. They're not acting, I mean, they're acting very differently than what they're talking about. And it's, for me, and for the Chinese, frankly, it's deeds. It's not words.
How about Iran? I mean, you know, you're saying it's one thing after another. President Biden, I think, wants to take us back into the nuclear deal with Iran. How could Biden go back into that deal? You think he will or try to?
I think if they do it, they're nuts. Here's why. Because President Trump, whether they liked what he did or not, the Biden administration is now in a great position, right? The Iranian economy is on its knees because of Trump sanctions, because of the low oil prices brought on largely because of American energy independence and the American fracking industry. The mullahs of Iran, the guys who run things, they're old, they're sick, and Iran is now dealing with a pandemic and they have no public health system. This is the time of maximum leverage on Iran. Use it. Negotiate a new deal, deal with their missiles, deal with their nuclear breakout issues. Because if the Biden administration goes back to the good old days of the fake Iran nuclear deal, then they're going to ignite a nuclear arms race in the Middle East because Iran is going to get nuclear weapons with a Biden nuke deal.
Warned on China, warned on Iran. Katie McFarland, thank you. We appreciate you being here. Okay, see you soon.
Thanks, Stuart.